Yet, Father, we stand in awe of what we celebrate. How can it be that the all-sufficient God of the universe became a helpless child resting in a feed trough? How can it be that the hands that once sculpted mountain ranges, now made flesh, reached the grab hold of a loving mother's finger? We don't know. Yet it happened. Jesus came, the visible expression of the invisible God, to bring God to us and us to God. The darkness of this world at times seems overwhelming, but in the midst of the darkness, we again see the light of Christmas, the light that cannot be overcome. It is before Him we bow down and worship. And in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, Amen. We will now have the lighting of our Advent candles by Earl and Ella Ford.
Tonight, as Advent comes to a close, we celebrate the arrival of Emmanuel, God with us. We marvel together at the mystery. We see the candlelight burning and long for more light within. More than ever, this year, O come, Emmanuel.
Coming is coming. Let us welcome love the guest. We know we are a mess. We know we have work to do, but we decorate anyway, and we wait with great expectation. May the guest we welcome again tonight renew our hope and strengthen our faith, refresh our joy, and dwell with us in peace.
Hear and marvel at the word from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressors, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots and the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Advent hope moves us. Advent faith motivates us. Advent joy stirs us. Advent peace stirs us.
Son, Jesus, to be God with us, Emmanuel. Advent love leads us to affirm our King Jesus, babe born in Bethlehem.
We believe that Jesus is the Son of God. He was born of the Virgin Mary in Bethlehem, Judea. He was the long-awaited Messiah, whose coming was prophesied. The same Jesus lives today in our hearts. He deserves our highest loyalty and total commitment.
verses 1 through 19. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all men to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that, while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart.
As you all know, this has been a most difficult year for all of us. I've read that this year our nation endured a record number of hurricanes, at least 30, along with wildfires, floods, and heat waves. And we've seen great social unrest and destruction on the streets of several of our major cities, historic statues destroyed and removed, stores, churches, office buildings, government buildings burned, angry rioters demanding that our police be defunded and law enforcement agencies be disbanded. And it seems we have politicians and news media hoping to gain some advantage for themselves by deepening the divide between us, arguing that all those in opposition are motivated by racism or greed. Politics, hand in glove with our media. Some reports that seem credible are saying that the source of some of our present troubles come from foreign and unfriendly governments waging war against us in unprecedented and unconventional ways. We are presently living through the uncertainty of our recent presidential election. The final outcome is still unknown, just as which party will control the Senate is unknown. Since the beginning of this year, the coronavirus has threatened our lives and taken others, kept us masked and distanced, and made us all anxious, even tonight. peace of mind and our peace of heart has depended on the certainty of the stock market, or on a stable political environment with trustworthy politicians, or on our own immune system and good health. We have reason to be disturbed. There are a lot of wonderful things to enjoy in this world, but this world is not our home. This world is temporary, just as we all are. This life is the short one. The good news of Christmas is that we all have a Savior who is Christ the Lord, and who gives light in our darkness, strength in our weakness, and hope in our despair. We have a Savior who was not caught off guard by anything that transpired in 2020. We have a Savior who is very pointed and very firm when he says to us, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go there to prepare a place for you? And if I go there to prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also." As wonderful and as disturbing as the world might be at times, this is not our home. Our home is with the Father. So do not let your hearts be troubled. The psalm writers were expressing their deepest convictions about the meaning of Christmas when they wrote lines like these: "Yet in thy dark streets shineth the everlasting light, the hopes and fears of all the years are met in Christ tonight." In the bleak midwinter, as Adele sang, the frosty wind moaned, the earth stood hard as iron, water was like a stone. Snow had fallen. Snow on snow. Snow on snow. Snow on snow. The coldness, the hardness, the moaning seemed endless. And yet it was in the bleak midwinter that a stable place sufficed as earth received her Savior, Jesus Christ. Long lay the world in sin and error, pining, yearning. Till Christ appeared, and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morning. Thanks be to God. Some of us here tonight need a new and glorious morning, a new day, renewed hope, a changed life. Tonight is only a commemoration of the real thing, but if you will allow me, Christ will do something new your life overnight. Christ can be born in your heart tonight, and for you tomorrow can be that new and glorious morning. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Amen. proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen.
And now the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You created light out of darkness and brought forth life on the earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. In the fullness of time, you gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. And at his birth, the angels sang, "Glory to you in the highest, and peace to your people on earth." And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. As your word became flesh, born of woman on that night long ago, so on the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to the disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again.
Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, if you would take your packet that was handed to you as you entered, and just remove the first layer, uncover the wafer. Because say thank you to our singers and musicians leading us in worship tonight. I've heard Azari play the bells all week later tonight. Thank you. All of you, thank you. It would not be Christmas without a song in the air. I'm just curious to know how many of you received a recent email from the church and have been able to see the video of It Is Well With My Soul. Would you raise your hand? Okay, if you haven't, and you haven't seen the email, that went to your junk file, look up Hugh Bonneville and It Is Well With My Soul. I cannot oversell this. It will bless you immensely. We will not have our candlelight lighting service tonight, but we hope that what has been figurative in previous services will be literal tonight, that you will take the light of Christ with you into the world, and that the goodness of Christ will shine forth in the darkness, and may God be glorified. Thank you for being here tonight. We pray that your time with family and friends and your celebration of Christmas include meditating on the true meaning of this season. What we truly need, what we truly desire, cannot be packaged and put in the tree. So let us go from this place proclaiming that we have seen the glory of God, believing that there is a light that shines in the darkness, which darkness cannot overcome. And may the love of the Creator, the joy of the Holy Spirit, and the peace of the Christ child be with you.